everybody. Welcome back.
It's been said the shortest distance between two people is a smile, but what happens when your smile is the one thing you hate about yourself?
Yeah, I understand. I mean, I used to have all kind of chopped up teeth. And
Look at those choppers now, baby.
This week on The Doctor Is In, we meet a young woman who says that her smile is anything but happy.
There are few things more important to feeling beautiful than having an attractive smile. It's the key to a good first impression that has eluded 22-year-old Jennifer Hargrave since the other kids made cruel fun of her.
I remember one day in sixth grade and a little boy came up to me and I was smiling and he told me that I looked like a horse.
It was a biting cut that has never gone away.
And that kind of stuck with me, you know, for my entire life, really.
Here is what Jennifer says is wrong.
When I smile, I have really big gums, and I have really tiny teeth in comparison to my gums.
She does her best to compensate for the perceived defect.
I cover my mouth because I'm very aware of it.
But the gum problem affects her confidence, her friendships, and her dating life.
I get a little more aware of it around a new crowd of people, new guys.
So we introduce the patient to periodontist Edward Gottesman.
I'm very excited about it, and I think that it's really gonna impact me a lot. I'm really gonna up my game, I guess.
Hi.
Hi, Jennifer, how are you?
Good.
Right away, he went to work
as well
to give Jennifer a brand new smile.
Ooh, all righty. Jennifer is here.
She's here.
But let's first see that before picture. We want to take a look at the before picture. Okay. There's some gums going on there. There's some gums.
Yeah, but not so bad.
Not so bad, but she didn't like them.
She was cute before.
She was, but she was insecure about it. Here's Jennifer after the procedure. Let's see your new smile.
Oh,
yay!
Wow. What a difference.
Look at you.
What a difference.
So wait, so what, let me see. I'm analyzing your face. So doctor, we have our doctor here, actually, the person who did this. The dentist,
Edward Gottesman. Did you lengthen her teeth?
As a matter of fact, we did. Her teeth were, to begin with, very short because she actually had very, very large upper jaw development. So what we had to do was correct for that with a crown lengthening procedure, yeah.
So it's basically you put crowns on the teeth.
Actually, she's never had any crowns at all. Her teeth were always there. They were just concealed. And all we had to do was reveal them to everybody. She had a beautiful smile, but you couldn't see it till now.
What do you mean reveal them? How did you reveal them?
Well, what we had to do was we had to correct for the short teeth by removing some gum tissue.
Oh, so you don't just stretch the teeth.
No,
you
no.
You shrink the gum.
That's it. We just remove some gum tissue.
I get
exactly.
You're shrinking
I get
the gum. Are you happy?
That's the truth.
I have never been so happy in my life.
Oh, you look so pretty.
Amazing.
How has it changed your life?
I have so much more confidence now. I can get out there and just meet people, just do everything like a normal kid now.
Yay!
Was it a major thing? I mean, did it hurt?
It didn't hurt at all.
Really?
Yeah, didn't hurt at all.
How is that possible? Did you give her lots of Novocaine?
Yeah, as a matter of fact.
A little laughing gas?
A little bit. Not laughing gas.
That blue light on the ceiling.
A little bit of Novocaine and about an hour worth of work.
How much does that cost? I hate to keep going back to that.
Well, it's variable.
We need to tell her, yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty variable. I mean, it could be anywhere from $2,500 to $5,000, depending on where in the country you go.
Dr. Mark Siegel joins
us. Hey, Doc.
You know what I want to say about this is, first of all, you have to go to someone like him who is really an expert in this. You don't want cosmetic procedures to be done by the wrong people. Secondly, you got to make sure you really need it. If you know, some people are going to watch this and say, maybe I should get it. I only want it to be given to the people who really need it and can benefit from it psychologically. Third, it's a very well-tolerated procedure, but you also got to watch out for risk of infection. And make sure that you look beforehand, my area, vitamin deficiencies, things that can give you problems with the gums that are not cosmetic. First, rule that out.
Uh-huh. That makes a lot of sense then.
Your mom is out in the audience. Carol?
Yes.
Hey, what do you think?
Hi.
I think she looks beautiful, and I'm so happy for her.
Was she really, I mean, as a child, she was really embarrassed about it, and
I
even as
no
a young
idea.
Woman.
I seriously had no idea. She was herself around us, but obviously in front of her friends, she was really upset about it.
So all people that have little teeth, their teeth are really hiding in their gums?
Frequently, that's the problem. And it's really easy to correct. It's
yeah,
a simple crown lengthening
so.
Procedure. And in addition, because her case was so advanced, we actually had to also lower her lip. So we
lower
did
her lip?
Yeah,
how
yeah.
did you do, wait, hold on a second, Jack. How'd you do that?
It's called a lip repositioning procedure. And it's quite simple. I mean,
you do it with lipstick?
No, no. Not that simple.
How did you do it?
Well, under local anesthesia, we just take a little bit of the inside of the lip away and just suture it a little lower down.
That's another key point here, was this, the whole procedure was able to be done under local anesthesia. That, because when you start getting into general anesthesia, yeah, it's a bigger issue. But this was done locally and looks beautiful.
You look sensational.
You do look great. She's, she obviously knows she does. She's smiling like crazy.
Yeah, right.
For more information on the procedure Jennifer had, you can go to our website, emmajshow.com, and find out a little bit more.
Oh, coming up next, is water the way to clear your skin? You've heard that.
More doctors in.
He's in.